Locksley Resources announced that it produced high-grade antimony from its Desert Antimony Mine prospect. Julian Woodcock is technical advisor to Locksley. Julian, welcome to mining.com.au.
Hey, Michael, it's great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Julian, tell us about those metallurgical results and why it's significant.
This has been a great set of results, Michael. We've been progressing work on our Mojave project located in California in the USA, just 1.5 kilometers from the massive Mountain Pass mine, rare earth mine. And our antimony project, we've been undertaking some preliminary metallurgical test work. We provided a sample to the labs. We initially did a rougher flotation concentrate, which saw some great recoveries, about 85% into a con at 30%. And this new results is taking that rougher concentrate and taking it through a cleaning stage. So through the cleaning stage, we've seen some very, very high grades reporting to the concentrate. So after all cleaning stages, we achieved 68.1% antimony. And that essentially is almost pure stibnite. So pure stibnite, the antimony hosting mineral, would have a grade of about 71%. So we're very, very close to a very clean concentrate product. This just allows us to move the project forwards. The next steps, we're looking to take this concentrate and hopefully produce an antimony ingot or bar. So we're very excited that we'll be able to do that. In addition to this, we're also collecting a larger sample, sort of in excess of 250 kilograms, to allow us to produce even more concentrate for more test work. So it's been a great advancement for the metallurgical side for the project.
You also had some other significant milestone announcement. I want to get to that in a minute, Julian, but let's just keep with the metallurgical side. So what are the next steps over the next 12 months in terms of advancing the metallurgical work, and how will that fit into the larger project?
Yeah, so this larger sample that I've just mentioned will allow us to produce a much greater volume of concentrate. So the initial sample was only about 25 kilos, had a limited amount of concentrate, but it allows us to do the initial CITR test work on the flotation method and start to tweak that. This larger sample will allow us to further refine and optimize those flotation steps. And then we'll be looking to use that information and helping feed that into sort of scoping out pilot plant type designs. In addition, we've also got a collaboration agreement with Rice University that is investigating the use of deep eutectic solvents to take that concentrate and then produce antimony metal, which would sidestep the need to go for a pyrometallurgical process. So yeah, we'll be using this concentrate from this larger sample for investigating a whole load of other pathways.
Talk about the other announcement that was made today at Locksley, Julian.
Yeah, this is also quite exciting news. So we're advancing our exploration activities across many fronts out at Mojave Project. And part of the work that we've been doing there is field mapping programs. We've had a specialist structural geologist undertaking work for us. They undertook an initial mapping program earlier this year, sort of June, July time. And then they took the second phase of mapping program late August into September. Now, this second phase of mapping focused on extending the geology understanding to the north and the south of the Desert Antimony Mine prospect. And I'm really pleased to see that from that mapping, we've expanded the corridor, the structural zone, which is host to the mineralization. We've expanded it from a previous model of about 300 meters up to now about 1.2 kilometers. So a fourfold increase of the target corridor. And what we've seen in that target corridor are the structures, the shear zones, which connects through to where we've got the mineralization at Desert Antimony. And this is now going to forward onto a quite intensive sampling campaign across that zone. So that's really been a great output. In parallel to that, as part of the mapping, we went into a new area across the ground where we'd previously seen some elevated rare earth element rock chips. So that attracted us to an area. And then in that mapping campaign, we identified a shaft that showed that there'd been some historical mining on the ground. We got rock chips from that shaft, and really pleased to announce in the recent report to the ASX that we received a high assay grade of 216 grams per ton silver. So we now know that there's some silver prospectivity in a vein that's essentially about 2.5 kilometers to the southeast of the Desert Antimony Mine. We've seen in this mapping these north-northeast structures, which is the same orientation at Desert Antimony, across multiple areas across the tenement package or the claim package. So we're really seeing lots of flavors and indications that we could be part of a broader, larger mineralized system. So getting boots back on the ground in November and to start expanding off that mapping.
Are you seeing support for mining in the US? That's where you're based, Julian. Of course, there was the equity investment that was made in Trilogy Metals for its approval for Ambler, which really lifted the stock. And then before that, earlier this year, we also saw the equity investment into Lithium Americas.
Yes, that's a very good question. And I think the current administration operating in the US is significantly focused on onshoring supply of critical minerals to be mined and produced in the US. We've seen investments that the Trump administration has made into MP Materials, which is our neighbor, substantial investments there. So yeah, we see a lot of support. Our claims are all on federal lands, Bureau of Land Management managed ground. So we get that support, or we're working towards getting that additional support. We've certainly seen in the last year an improvement in the process in order to get the permits, etc., to undertake our field activity. So yes, to answer your question directly, a lot of support in the current administration there.
Julian, thanks for speaking with mining.com.au.
Thanks for having me, Michael.